What's going on, Weekend Hangover Nation? I'm your boy Surf, and I am back. I'm back with some Hangover news, and today I'm talking about the New Orleans Saints traded for Bradley Roby. Well, we sort of called this a few weeks ago. Writing was on the wall for the veteran corner. He just didn't line up for the Texans' timetable, so they moved him. What we didn't call was where, and honestly, that was my bad, guys. That was a total oversight by me. Saints are not only a great fit for Roby, but they're honestly the most obvious landing spot. A team with real need for supporting corner talent opposite Lattimore. Bradley Roby fills that need and then some. Saints fans should be salivating over that level of outside talent. Saints also signed veteran corner Desmond Trufant to further shore up the corner depth, and also add that Desmond Trufant card to the roster. You know what I mean? It looks pretty good, maybe about 5 years ago. What I love about the additions are the domino effect. With the arrival of Roby, the Saints won't be forced to rush the talented rookie Paulson Adebo or forced to rely on the journeyman Ken Crowley to play starter minutes on the outside. They can slide either down a nickel and let Adebo naturally progress, which is what I love. I hate throwing people to the fire. Sometimes that crushes guys like pre where they should get crushed. You know what I mean? Let them develop. Let them gain some confidence and then slide in. I'm less sold on Trufant at this point in his career. Can't stay healthy. And is honestly a shadow of him former self when he is on the field. He looked cooked in Detroit last season. Though, who knows? Healthy offseason with a new scheme might turn back the clock, and I'm just not betting on it. So what can the Saints expect to get out of Roby? He's always been more of a shutdown guy than a ball hawk. His 10 career interceptions in 7 seasons tells that story. What he does bring to the table is the ability to harass and get physical on the outside, and with the speed to run stride for stride with the fastest receivers in the NFL down the field. While his 64% completion percentage was a bit up for Roby in 2020, his 7.8 yards per catch jumps off the screen. Takes bend but don't break to another level, more like turning receivers into tight ends and just killing guys. Which honestly should pair well with Lattimore, who's the opposite. He doesn't get beat much, but when he does, watch out, and watch out deep. I expect that ridiculous 7 touchdowns he gave up in 2020 to come back down to earth, because that's just not acceptable for a player of Lattimore's caliber. I get it. You take chances, but man, that's getting cooked, man. 7 touchdowns, a lot. So fans, get excited. Saints fans, at least, get excited. Texans fans, well, there's a chance to see if any of these young corner pieces can emerge and be a future piece to build around, which in his own way, it's exciting. So, all right, guys, it's been another Weekend Hangover production. I'm your boy, Surf. Hit us up with a like, comment, subscribe, all that good stuff, and we'll be back with some more news. Catch you guys later. Peace.